Hello everyone, I am Asha Best. Hope you all are safe and happy at your places. Dear children, today I welcome you all in class 6, 4th chapter of history, maps. In this chapter, we'll discuss about map, its types, as well as the component of a map. So let's begin with the first part of this chapter. Maps. A map is a graphical representation of the Earth's surface on a flat sheet of paper. Maps are useful for a variety of reasons, such as demarcation of international borders and learning about natural Earth features. When several maps are put together, we get an atlas. Dear children, a map is a representation or drawing of the Earth's surface or a small part of the Earth's surface which is drawn on a flat surface in a right scale. But in reality, it is impossible to flatten a round shape completely. We use map for completely different purposes, dear children. Some maps are used for small areas and a few are used for large areas. Some maps may contain many facts, like a book. Okay, book which contains many types of maps from small scale to large scale, from few facts to many facts. And all together, if we get all these maps in one book, that one single book is known as atlas. Moving forward, types of maps. So let's discuss here the types of maps. Maps which show natural features of the earth, such as plains, mountains, plateaus, rivers, lakes, and oceans, are known as the physical maps. Here, one map is given in this picture. You can see this map is physiographic divisions of India. It is showing the physical divisions of our country. As I said, that majorly there are three types of maps we may see in our studies everywhere. Right from class 4, you must have studied about these types of maps. So let's have a closer look to these maps. Here right now we are talking about physical maps. These maps are showing us the physical divisions of our country. Physical maps are also known as relief maps. Then comes the political maps. When we talk about the political map, maps which show countries, states, cities, towns, and villages with their territorial borders are known as political maps. Here, one picture is also given in which you can see in our country, there are different states, cities, and towns. This map is a political map which is showing the states, cities, and towns. These are the maps which shows us the political boundaries. Okay, that is why these are known as political maps, as they show the political boundaries of a country. Like I said earlier also, the cities, towns, villages, state with their boundaries. Next comes thematic maps. Its name itself explaining its meaning. Maps which provide specific information such as rainfall, road, industries, forest, crop pattern are also as thematic maps. These maps focuses on specific information, as I said, like showing rainfall of a particular area, showing the population of a state or the country, showing the wildlife sanctuaries, the national parks, the vegetation, the rivers. These all are included in thematic maps as they provide us specific information. Here one picture is given. You can see this map is showing population of India in the year 2020. Now let's discuss components of a map. There are three main components of maps. First is distance. That is the most difficult and important component of map. Second comes direction, and finally symbols. Let's talk about these components in detail. First comes distance. It is impossible to draw the world on a tiny piece of paper as it is in the real. To solve this problem, we use a scale to represent the surface as closely as we can. A scale is a ratio between of actual distance on ground and distance shown on the map. Distance is the most difficult component, dear children, of a map to represent on a flattened surface. The real on the real ground. If we take actual distance in maps, then we would not be able to make a map for even for a small village, or even if I ask you without using a scale, draw the map of your school, you will not be able to draw it on a piece of paper. Because making a map in real scale, it is not at all possible. Though we reduce the distance between place to represent it on a map, we choose a scale to get the actual map in our paper. When entities like countries, continents or the world are shown on the map, then we use a small scale. Okay, in this case we use small scale. What is the scale that we earlier also talked about? That scale is the ratio between the actual distance shown on the map, actual distance, and the distance which is shown on the map. It is a ratio which is between the actual distance and the distance which is shown on the map. Here in this picture, you can see a line is drawn to show the distance between two places on a map. When you put a scale on it, the ruler, okay? If you put a ruler on it, then if you measure it using a ruler, then the distance between these two places, you will be definitely getting in centimeters. So that is the ratio which we have used to show the difference or of distance between these two places. Let's talk about the types of the small scale map and large scale map. When a large area is shown on a small map, such a map is called a small scale map. For example, map of a country or state, or you can say map which is showing the whole world or continents. Okay, that is the small scale map. I hope you are getting it. Small scale map, when we show the large areas like the countries and continents, I said, on a piece of paper, we use small scale. For example, like 5 centimeter, we use to show a distance of 500 kilometers. And let's talk about large scale map. When a small area such as a village is shown on a map, Such a map is called a large-scale map. A map of a neighborhood is another example of large-scale map. A large-scale map gives more details compared to a small-scale map. Means it gives us more detail if we compare it with the small-scale map. When we show large areas like countries and continents on paper, then we use small scale. Okay. And when we use small areas like villages on a map, then we use large scale maps. If I give you an example of that, of large scale map, we can say in a large scale map, 5 centimeters will be taken, this ratio will be taken for showing 500 meters on a map. That is the example of large scale map, where we show smaller areas. Smaller areas, large scale. Large areas, small scale. Now let's differentiate between large scale maps and small scale maps. When we talk about large scale map cover small area of land, and at the same time, small scale map cover large area of land. Small scale maps provide a great deal of details. They provide us maximum information, and small scale maps provide small amount of details to us. If we take example of large scale map, we can say a map which is showing a city or village. And when we talk about small scale map, the example of small scale map is world map or map which is showing the continents. Example, like I said earlier also, 1 centimeter represents 100 meters. This is the example of large scale map. And for small scale map, the example is 1 centimeter is showing 100 kilometers. So, I hope you enjoyed the lesson. This is all about the first part of this chapter. We'll soon meet with the second part of this chapter. Till then, take care all of you. Goodbye. Have a nice day.